Sag junctions, the junctions functional link between adjacent cells. So it is a link which is also for structure as well as functional link between adjacent cells. Sag junctions are of three types: tight junctions, adhering junctions, and gap junctions. Okay. So gap junction is this one. So it is leaving some gap for exchange of material, any gas or material. Tight junction will not allow any exchange. Okay. And adherence, just joining the two, adhere, joining the two things. Adhere means to join. Okay. So let's see first one now. So here they have given tight junction help to stop substance from leaking across tissue. Okay. So tight junction, they will not allow any substance to leak from one cell to another or from one tissue to another. Adhering junction performs cementing or to keep neighbor cells together. It is just like you add cement between two laterite stone. Okay. Between two stone, if you put cement, what will happen? They will join and stay together. That is adhering junction. Gap junction, it facilitates the cells to communicate with each other by connecting cytoplasm of adjoining cells for rapid transfer of large ions, small molecules, and big molecules. So this is gap junction. So if this light brown color is the cytoplasm of this is in contact with the cytoplasm of the other cell. So if cytoplasm is in contact, whatever is in the cell can easily move from here to here or from here to here. Now the things which will move is ions, small molecules, and big molecules. Got what is the three types of junction? Tight junction, like it does not allow anything to go out. Adhere junction, just to keep them in place. So your heart should not move from your chest to stomach. Heart should be there only. So your heart is in contact with the muscles by this adhere junction. Gap junction helps to transfer of material. Some cells require transport of material. So for that we have gap junction. Okay. These are desmosomes. This is gap junction, hemidesmosome. So important, you just copy this. What is tight junction? What is adhering junction? And what is gap junction? Next is connective tissue. Okay, what is the function of this tissue?
Connect.
Okay, it connects all the parts of the body. The best example is blood. Okay, the simple example is blood. Blood flows through entire body. That means it connects one part of the body to another. The blood also carry hormones. So hormones have to move from one gland to the target organ. So that is done by blood. So it connects. So connective tissue, it links and support other tissue and organs. Okay. It links and also it supports. It gives support to the other tissue and organs. Most abundant in complex animal. This is the most abundant. Out of all the tissue, connective tissue is the most abundant. All connective tissue except blood have fibroblast cells. All connective tissue except blood have fibroblast cells. These are all fibroblast cells. Okay, you can see like fiber, fibroblast. Okay. They secrete fibrous protein called collagen and elastin. So this fibroblast cell will secrete fibrous protein called collagen and elastin. Now, this gives strength, elasticity, and flexibility to tissue. From the word elastin only, you can say elasticity and flexibility. So, this gives strength, elasticity, and flexibility to tissue. The cells also secrete modified polysaccharide called matrix, which accumulate between the cells and fiber. So, this, you can see this is matrix. Okay. These are fibers, fibroblast cells, fibroblast cell, this is collagen fiber, this is elastin fiber, and everything what is in between is like matrix, matrix which accumulate between cells and fibers. So between the cell and fiber there will be matrix. So this is very important. Next slide we'll see first. Okay, now connective tissue, they are loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue and specialized connective tissue. Under loose connective tissue we have areolar tissue or adipose tissue. Areolar tissue is tissue just below the skin. Adipose tissue is the tissue which forms a pad around the organ. Every organ there will be a pad. What is pad? Cricket pad, you all know, no? Cricket batting pad. Why they wear pad? To protect. So to protect each and every organ, there is a pad of adipose tissue which is made up of fat. So it gives softness to the organ from the outside. Dense connective tissue, we have dense regular and dense irregular. We'll see what is this later. Specialized connective tissue, we have cartilage, bone and blood. Okay, so so loose connective tissue, first one is, in this cell fibroblast, macrophages, mast cell. Okay, in this cells are like fibroblast, macrophages and mast cell. Macrophages are cells which help in digesting the germs, like foreign particle you can say. Mast cell, mostly you can say the cells which are found on a wound. Wound pe baad mein wo dawa, that is actually mast cell. Okay. Fibers, okay, cells and fibers are loosely arranged in a semi-fluid matrix. They are loosely arranged. Okay. It is of two types, areolar and adipose. So it is of two types. Areolar, so you can see it is loosely arranged. Loose they are. Loose connective, areolar just present beneath the skin. As I have told you already, this whatever I am pulling is areolar, just present below the skin. It serves as a support framework for epithelium. It just serves framework for epithelium. Which tissue we are studying now? Connective. Now on this connective tissue, there is epithelial tissue. So it is like framework. On this connective tissue, that is areolar tissue, we have all our epithelial, outside epithelial tissue. Okay. Now this gives elasticity and strength. Elasticity. This elasticity we get. That is areolar. So here you can see areolar tissue. This is mast cell, macrophages, fibroblast, collagen fiber, and they are loosely arranged. Next one is adipose tissue. The loose connective tissue type 2 is adipose. Seen mainly beneath the skin. Now below the areolar tissue, there will be one more, adipose. Mostly beneath the skin. It says adipocytes stores fat. That means it stores fat. Okay, this adipocyte, the cells are called as adipocytes, which stores fat. Excess nutrients are converted into fats and stored into its tissue. So whatever excess nutrient which we eat, which is not used by the body, it is converted into fat and stored in this tissue. This is also found around the organs. Okay, just gives protection to the organs. Then dense connective tissue means fibers and fibroblasts are compactly packed. There are two types, dense regular connective tissue and dense irregular connective tissue. So we have two types. This, the dense regular connective tissue shows regular pattern of fibers, pattern rahega. Collagen fibers are present in rows between many parallel bundles of fibers. Okay, bundle of fibers, there is row. Example is tendons and ligaments. So you all have studied this. What is tendons function?
Lubricate,
okay. Tendons and ligaments, it connects something to something.
Muscle to
bone. Yeah, tendons connects muscle to bone and ligaments connects bone to bone. Okay. So here, tendons attaches skeletal muscle to bone and ligaments attaches one bone to the other. This is dense regular connective tissue. So tendons, you can see here, muscle to bone, okay, muscle to the bone, ligaments, bone to the bone. This is one bone, this is other. So this ligaments connect bone to the bone. Okay, dense connective tissue, dense regular, irregular pattern of irregular fibroblasts and fibers, mostly collagen is present in skin. Okay, this is present in skin, irregular pattern. Okay, so this is dense regular and dense irregular. Tendons and ligaments function, you have to know. In this tendons, ligaments, so what you will write is, we'll write first about adipose and areola. Okay.